Good morning all of you. As we were studying the chapter direct and inverse proportion, we have completed exercise 13.1 and in that we have studied about the direct proportion. Now we will study here in the second exercise 13.2 till question number 5 we have solved. From today we will start with question number 6. So firstly we have to judge whether the question is in direct proportion or indirect proportion. Okay, so first here in this question it is saying a contractor estimates that 3% could rewire this member's house in 4 days. Means a contractor is there, he has made an estimation that three person will rewire this Minder house in 4 days. Means 3% will rewire in 4 days. Okay, if he uses 4% instead of the 3, means first he has estimated that if 3% he will take to revive Jasvinder's house, so it will take 3% and complete it in 4 days. So instead of 3, if he uses 4%, so you have to find out how long should they take to complete the job. So you have to find out the number of days. Means this you have to find out. So have you understood the question? In this question it is saying that for the revival of Jasvinder's house, the contractor, he estimated that 3% will complete this job in how many days? 4%. So what he got, instead of 3%, if he uses number of person as 4, so how, this 4%, how many days it will take to complete the job? You have to find out the number of days. Okay, so now we have to find out that whether this is in inverse proportion or in direct proportion. Okay, so yes, let me give you an example. Let's suppose if one pen, it costs rupees 10 rupees. Okay, if one pen, it is, what is the cost of one pen? 10 rupees. If you will take 2 pen, this will cost rupees 20. If you take 3 pens, it will cost rupees 30 rupees. So here in this question you are saying, as you have increased the number of pens, the number of the cost is also increasing. In both the case, number of pen is increasing, so number of the cost of the pen is also increasing. So this is in direct proportion, and the vice versa it happens in the indirect proportion. Indirect proportion means if one is increasing, the other will decrease, or if one is decreasing, the other will increase. So this is direct proportion, and the vice versa for this will be indirect proportion. So from here you have to check that this question is in direct proportion or this is in indirect proportion. So here what it is given to you, 3 persons have completed the job in, will complete the job in 4 days. This is an estimation. So 4% will complete in how many days? As you have seen, what is given to you here is number of person, and what is given to you as number of days. So if the number of person is 3 persons, it will complete in 4 days. If the number of person is 4, it will complete in how many days? You have to find out. So as you know, as we increase the number of, as the number of person is 3, so it is taking 4 days. And if you increase the number of person, so will the number of day increase, or it will increase, or it will decrease? Just think, if I am doing any work, if more people are there, they will complete it in less time. More people are there, they will complete it in less time. And if less people are there, they will complete it in more time. So here I have increased the number of people. So what will be the number of days? More or less? Just think for 2 minutes. If you are like 5 students, I have given them to complete the work. Suppose they are taking it 3 hours to complete. A work is assigned to 5 students, and these 5 students are completing the work in 3 hours. So if I will increase this, my student is 10 student. How much time they will take? Maybe they will do this in 1.5 hours. Yes or no? So as the number of person you will increase, the time will, what will happen? The time will decrease. So one is increasing, number of person is increasing. So the time is decreasing here. Here also you can see, this is 3. So the number of days, it is more. If you will increase the number of person, the number of days will decrease. And in inverse proportion, this only happens if one is increasing, the other will decrease. In direct proportion, both the things will decrease, or in both the things it will increase. Okay, so this question is in which form? This is in inverse proportion. So what we have to do here, the number of person is 3. This person will complete the days. How many days? 4. And if you increase the number of person, so how many days it will complete? How many days it will take to complete? So let the number of days be equal to x. As you have seen that this is in inverse proportion. In inverse proportion, what we do? We multiply this things. Means 3 into 4 will be equal to how much? 4 into x. 3 into 4 will be equal to how much? 4 into x. Now 3 into 4, this will be equal to 4 into x. So we have to find out the value of x. Here it is in multiplication. On going on the other side, it will be in division. So from here x, and this will be 4. So this 4 and this 4 gets cancelled. So here x equal to how much? 3. So here x we have taken as the number of days. So here the number of days will be 3. From here you can see the number of person here is 3. So the number of person, so number of days is increases. If you have increased the number of person, the number of days decrease. So this question was in the inverse proportion. This is exercise 13.2, question number 7. Here, as I have told you, in the question it will be not be given to you that whether the question is in direct proportion or indirect proportion. You have to find out that is the question in direct proportion or indirect proportion. So let's see the question. Question number 7. A batch of bottles were packed in 25 boxes with 12 bottles. Okay. A batch of bottles were there. They were packed in 25 boxes. They were packed in 25 boxes, and each boxes it contains 12 bottles. Each means one. One box it contains 12 bottles. So the question is, a batch of boxes were there and were packed in 25 boxes. This batch of boxes were packed in 25 boxes, and each bag means one box. In one box you can pack how many bottles? 12 bottles. Okay. So next question it is saying, if the same batch is packed, means the batch will be same. If the same batch is packed using 20 bottles, so the same batches of the same batch will be packed with, instead of 12, if I packed it with 20 bottles, so you have to find out what will be the number of box required here. Okay, understood the question? A batch of bottles are there, and these bottles are packed in 25 boxes. One box is containing how many bottles? 12 bottles. If the question it is saying, if instead of this one box it carries 12 bottles, if this one box it carries how many? 20 bottles. How many such boxes will be required to complete this batches? Okay, so here I am writing down. This is here I am writing number of bottles in each box. Okay, so in this way you have to write. So what is the number of boxes given to you? You are given with number of boxes and number of bottles. So number of boxes is given to you 25 boxes. Okay, and how what in 25 boxes, one box will carry how much? 12 bottles. Okay, so if I number of boxes will carry in one box is 12. So if I instead of this 12 bottles, if I use 20 bottles in each box, so you have to find out number of the boxes required. So from here, as you are seeing, the number of boxes are 20, the number of boxes are 25 and the bottle it is containing 12. So what will be the number of boxes? So the it will contain how much? 20 bottles. So here you have to find out the whether it is in inverse proportion or it is in direct proportion. So here I am writing bottle and what I will write down? Boxes. Okay, so what will happen if you increase the number of bottle? Here you can see the number of boxes will decrease, correct or not? Here if I increase the number of bottle, the number of boxes will, what will happen? The boxes will decrease. So this question will be in the inverse proportion. As I will increase the number of bottles, the number of boxes here it will decrease. So let's suppose the number of boxes be here x. If 25 boxes are there, 12 bottles are there, it is taking 25 boxes. If I have increased the number of bottles, means number of bottles I will increase. What will happen? The number of boxes will decrease. So your question is in the inverse proportion. So in the inverse proportion, you know what we do? We multiply this to 25 into 12 and we multiply this to this x into 20 is there. Find out the value of x. So here it will be 25 into 12, x will be, it is a multiplication, on coming on the other side it will become division. Okay, so from here you will, if you cancel this, you it will be 2 6s are 2 10s are 5 2s are 5 5s are 2 1s are and 2 3s are. So it is 5 into 3 is 15. So x here it will be how much? 15. So the number of boxes required here will be how much? 15. So from here only you can see the number of bottles were less, so the number of boxes were more. So now you have increased the number of bottles, so the number of boxes is decreased. Okay, as you have seen, the value of x is 15. That means the number of boxes required is how much? 15. This is question number 8. Here in this question it is saying a factory requires 42 machines to produce a given number of articles in 63 days. Okay, so here it is given 42 machines are there to produce a given number of articles. Given number of articles, here it is given number of articles. Okay, so 42 machines will produce a number of articles in how many days? 63 days. So how many machines would require to produce the same number of articles? Means here it is asking how many machines will require to produce same number of articles. Means this number of articles and this number of articles are same, but how many machines would be required to produce the same number of articles in days? It is here it is given as 54 days. Okay, so here what is given to you? Number of machine is given to you and number of days is given to you, and the number of article both are same in both the condition. Number of article is same. Let us suppose the number of article be 100. For making this, I am supposing it. Now it is not given in the question. Let assume this. Here the number of articles is 100. So 100 articles, 42 machine will completed in 63 days. These same number of articles. 100 articles are there. So how many machines will it require so that it can complete it in 54 days? So here in the question, you have to judge whether the question is in direct proportion or in indirect proportion. Here number of machine is given, article is in, and 42 machine will complete in 63 days. So more machine, less days, less machine, more days. Okay, less machines are there, so it will complete in more days, and if more machines it will be taking, it will take less days. So here the number of days is decreased, so the machine will be what? If I increase, I am increasing the number of machine, then the number of days will be decreased. So here this question is in the inverse proportion. So from here I can write down. Okay, let me write down this way. So what I will write down? Number of machine and number of days. So if 42 machines are there, it is completing in 63 days. So what you have to find out, number of days are given, you have to find out how many machines will it require to complete that number of article. So let the number of machine be X. I am taking like the number of machine be X. If number of machine is increased, the days will decrease. So the question is in inverse proportion. Similarly, if the number of machine will increase, the days will decrease. If the number of machine will decrease, the days will increase. Okay. So here this question is inverse proportion. So inverse proportion, 42 into 63 will be equal to X into 54. You can write down in this pattern, na? Like this. This question you have to write down in this table. Like this. Make these columns and write down the questions. Okay? So now you are clear with this. So multiply. Solve this. You will get 42 into 63. This is in multiplication. So here it will be in division. Cancel this. You will get 2 2s are 2 1s are 2 2s are 2 7s are. Okay, again you can cancel it with 3 3 7s are 3 9s are. Again with 3 3 3s are 3 2s are 6 3 1s are 3 1s are. Again with 3 7s are. So 7 into 7 is 49. So the value of X here is 49. So X here is 49. So instead of this X, you can write 49. So the number of machine is 42. So means less machines are there, more days it is taking. Okay. Again, number of machine is increased. Means it has increased to 49. So it will complete in less number of days. So have you understood direct and indirect proportion? In direct proportion, both the things will increase. Okay, or decrease. Similarly, in indirect proportion, one will increase, the other will decrease, or other will decrease, the first one will increase. So this is the way to find out whether the question is in direct proportion or indirect proportion.